One of the things, first things that comes out right away is this, central administration and the first initial team side that was created for you. So central administration looks pretty much the same. There's some of the things we can probably expect to change, like some of those icons here, but it looks very similar to 2010. Obviously, some of the administration functions are going to change as new functionality will be rolled out to us. But all in all, we go to application management, system settings. All of those things are actually same pages as 2010 had. So there's a couple of new things such as apps, right? There's a whole new concept of apps and app store and how that's going to be, managed and licensed and all that. So one of the biggest complaints that was out there is that central administration and is not really the same thing as regular SharePoint sites. So folks were complaining about the fact that they can't customize the page and stuff like that. So your wishes are now granted. So now you've got browse and a page view where you can edit the page and customize things and stuff like that. So some of the out of the box collaboration capability has been added to central administration. Now let's take a look at the team side. So team side. This is a team site, right? So important thing to keep in mind is, so first thing you're gonna ask, just as you would probably ask in previous versions, is where is the site settings? So site settings moved back to the right now. It's not the focal point of the whole site anymore, and it's this little icon here, right? So right beside your name, there's this icon where you can add a page add an app. So important thing is that everything is an app right now. So lists and libraries, former lists and libraries are now apps, right? So when you want to add, let's say a calendar, right? It's not no longer considered a list. It's an app, right? It's a calendar app. So there's a document library app, tasks app, custom list app, also called as app. So those are some of the things to keep in mind. So for instance, if I want to add a calendar, I can add it like this. It gives me more details. So you can, as a developer, as you expect when you're going to be customizing your sites and adding lists and such and web parts, keep in mind that they're going to be available to users in the form of an app. So I'm trying to add here a calendar, and obviously something is going wrong. So sorry, something went wrong. Error comes up. So I guess I'm going to go back to my team site and try to do some other functionality like editing this particular team site page. So one of the, is again the same sort of loose wiki editing format is preserved here. I can basically edit and add content wherever I feel like, right? This is really a wiki page. When I'm ready, I just click save and close. Some of the other things here is the full screen or the tablet view, which basically gets rid of all the extraneous content. And it's actually a pretty cool feature because I remember lots of my clients asked for, sort of a, give them more of a tablet look and feel. And that's started being more apparent in the past year or so. A lot more people were getting tablets and trying to use SharePoint on their tablet. And there's just too many menus that were, like, in here, it's not a big deal that this takes half of your screen or a quarter of your screen, right? But if I'm using really a tablet, this is really half of my screen. So by there's this feature available, or focus on content feature, that allows you kind of to get rid of all the extraneous stuff and just focus on really on content. So one of the other things that I wanted to also point out is the whole usability around document sharing and adding a document has been a little bit improved. So here I have an ability to add a document right from my file system. But one of the things that I can do also, and that's something that I've been asked before by multiple users, is how do you easily just drag and drop stuff? So it's like this now. So very easy, you just drag and drop If you've seen this particular functionality is available in Dropbox. And what's good about it is that really without any effort, I can just drag and drop multiple documents here. So I don't have to worry about, you know, clicking upload multiple and going to the ribbon. So the ribbon is still here, right? You can probably see there is the rumors that ribbon is going to be gone are gone because ribbon is still here, right? But it's lesser of a focus on a ribbon. So, which is actually a pretty smart move if you think about users, you know, just apart from just cutting off the functionality, like the start menu on the Windows 2012 server is completely cut off. Rather than cutting off the functionality, I'd much rather prefer refocus to something else and then give up that functionality gradually rather than just not have it available. It would be really frustrating. So I'm glad that frustration has been resolved by using that particular approach. So accessing the context menu is not really too apparent. There's this three dots here where you can just access the content menu of the particular item, and that gives you some of the basic capabilities here. We'll talk about some of those later on.